Hey guys, welcome back to the garden and a happy new month to you all. So the beginning of August marks the end of winter for us here in Zimbabwe and the beginning of spring. There's going to be a lot of things to do in the garden, guys. So if you'd like to catch up with what I'll be doing in my garden this month of August, make sure that you subscribe to my channel and hit that notification bell so that you won't miss out on any of the activities that I will be doing in my garden. Okay, so in today's video, I want to do a check-in on my worm bin that I built using elephant dung. So guys, come along with me and let me show you how this bin is progressing. Okay guys, so this is the worm bin here, the one that was built using cow dung as bedding. So let's open this bin and see how the worms are doing. So you can see that on the top of the bin I've got a plastic covering. I've also got a newspaper covering below the plastic so that the moisture is not going to escape. Okay guys, on the top of the bin you can see that there is evidence of some worm action. You can see that there are deposits of worm castings on top of the bin, right on the surface of the bin, so this shows me that the worms are doing very well. So the purpose of this bin was that I wanted to multiply my red wriggler population. So this bin contains only red wrigglers, so I want the red wrigglers to lay their cocoons inside this bin so that they are going to multiply, and I'm going to have a substantial amount of red wrigglers that I can use to compost my waste. So let's try and see if they are doing well inside this bin. So what I've been doing from the last time that I showed you this bin, I've been taking our used tea bags and depositing them inside this bin for the worms to eat. So with this amount of castings that I'm seeing on top of this bin, I'm sure that the worms are enjoying this used tea bags, because this is the only source of food that I've been putting inside this bin besides this tissue paper that you see over here. Okay guys, so let's try and see if we can find cocoons in here. If we can find any, I can know that my plan is working. I'm going to multiply my red wriggler population. Let's try and see if we can find a cocoon. Okay guys, there's a cocoon over here. So my plan is working guys, my red wrigglers are multiplying. Let's try and see. Okay, here are some two cocoons over here. I've got one over here and another one over there. Okay guys, so three cocoons are sign enough to show me that my plan is working, and very soon I'll be able to build up my red wriggler population so that I can start composting more using red wrigglers. So this is the state of the bin guys. I'm sure you can see that the worms are happy, judging from the amount of castings that we are seeing on top of this bin. So guys, before I go, let me try and show you the worms that are inside this bin. Look at that guys. Okay guys, so over to the next thing. So I've just finished building this new bin and it has got a mixture of red wrigglers and African night crawlers. So on top of the bin I've placed some egg cartons in which I can pour water and it can slowly seep inside the bin to moisten the bin. So this is a trick that I learned from Matty's garden. So I'm going to leave a link to Matty's garden's channel in the description below. Okay guys, so in this bin I've used cow dung and rabbit bedding to build it, and I'm sure the worms are going to go crazy over the cow dung and the rabbit bedding. Thank you guys for watching this video, and I'm going to see you in the next video.